elections matter, not as much the politics of it, but that helps us assess in a way the policy shifts that the world may be facing in the next quarters and years. It is probably even more important today as the world emerges slowly out of this unprecedented COVID-19 crisis, which left us with additional challenges. Leaders of today and tomorrow will also have to face climate change transition, will have to face demographic shifts, and probably embrace all this new digitalization. Now, what do we have in store in terms of elections for the next years? We have some probably positive outcomes to expect in Europe, a political gridlock likely in the United States, but also some elections which can trigger some risky events, and I would think there of Northern Ireland and Latin America. There is possibility of thinking about some positive outcomes in Europe, which is facing important elections in the core countries of the region. And we may just be about to see a triumvirate of Franco-German-Italian settling in for a more progressive Europe. To start with Germany, where elections are just behind us, by the looks of it, the finance minister SPD, Olaf Scholz, is likely to take the baton from Chancellor Angela Merkel. With a traffic light coalition, SPD, FDP and the Greens likely up and running by Christmas 2021. As we head into 2022, Italian presidential elections will draw our attention. And they're not so much as per the president per se, but likely to give us comfort or not whether Prime Minister Mario Draghi will receive the mandate to stay and to run and implement successfully the EU Next Generation Investment Programme. But for sure the climax will be May 2022 with French presidential elections taking place. And so far, polls indicate that incumbent president Emmanuel Macron is likely to win a second mandate and grant policy continuity. So yes, we are just about at a moment in time when Europe, the European trio, Draghi, Macron and Scholz, will probably bring in this genuine alignment of stars for a more progressive Europe, whether it is on Europe's fiscal policy, fiscal reform overall. So that is a positive. Now, moving on the other side of the pond, the United States is looking for its midterm elections, and there we are looking for a political gridlock. History says it so as well. It is very usual that the party that runs the Congress, that has the majority in the Congress, loses generally, on average, more seats than the Democrats today are even affording to lose. Additionally, administration of President Biden has also shown some tensions within the Democratic Party, which not only has trimmed infrastructure program spending that Biden has campaigned on, but also likely has dented his popularity, as opinion polls are saying. So overall, a gridlock in the political landscape as of the midterms, which means that the Biden administration is probably going to move away from domestic policy more into international agenda. Needless to say that the midterms do mark the countdown for the next pivotal 2024 US elections, which will have important implications for, not to say the least, the US climate change commitments and also geopolitics more broadly speaking. Now, if we move more into darker areas where elections could trigger more risk events, I would name there a few. First of all, Northern Ireland, which is running elections in May 2022 and which could trigger, again, reignite Brexit tensions. And some of the democratic institutions could collapse. As per se, this is an important event that could trigger, again, a reunification bid. Now, if I take you a bit further away, in Latin America, we will see several important elections there, whether it is the presidential elections in Brazil or Colombia, but also a referendum on the constitutional reform in Chile. And as you may know, this region remains in a very vivid social tension, and as growth is slowly recovering from its strong rebound it meant last year, it has rational to see social unrest unfolding related to those events where a lot of populists are running for election. Now, what does that mean for investors per se? You may know elections always trigger idiosyncratic events, but sometimes have some regional aspects. Now, our European base case is obviously pretty positive for Eurozone government bond yields. It's also probably positive for tighter peripheral spreads and supportive for euro. Needless to say that any of those three events not unfolding as we expect, that could trigger the reverse. In the US, the midterms are likely to be not so much an event for the fixed income market, but could weigh slightly on the dollar. If we move to Northern Ireland, it's the sterling that will probably bear the brunt of the pain. But a Northern Ireland protocol will likely also weigh on the FTSE 250 on the equity market. Now, in Latin America, I would say elections and political tensions are likely to weigh on the currencies and the local markets. But we wouldn't consider, per se, those events to be any kind of trigger for an EM contagion event so far as things stand. Thank you.